Lucy Hobbs Taylor is the first American woman to graduate from dental school. Taylor was born in New York in 1833 and was first a school teacher before pursuing her dentistry degree. Because of her gender, she was denied admission to multiple schools. But one dentistry professional, Dr. Samuel Wardle, agreed to tutor her in his office. And she was able to develop the skill set needed to open her own practice. Because of her success, she was then able to enroll in Ohio College of Dentistry, which previously denied her entry, to become the first woman in the world to receive a doctorate in dentistry. She then married Civil War vet James Myrtle Taylor, taught him the trade, and moved to Lawrence to establish a joint practice. The Taylors created one of the most successful practices in Kansas. All the while, Lucy devoted her time to charity and social causes, namely women's rights. Today, the American Association of Women Dentists recognizes outstanding women in the dental profession with the Lucy Hobbs Taylor Award. Erin Brockovich is a legal clerk and environmental activist from Lawrence. She is famously known for her successful lawsuit against the Pacific Gas and Electric Company and for Julia Roberts playing her in a movie. The lawsuit alleged that drinking water in the Southern California town of Hinckley was contaminated. The case settled in 1996 for $333 million, the largest settlement ever paid in a direct action lawsuit.
Well, I'm paraphrasing here, but it says, yes, the water's poisonous, but it would be better for all involved if this matter was not discussed with the neighbors. It's to the Hinckley station from PG&E headquarters. Stamp received March 1966.
Brockovich is now the president of her own consulting company and works as a consultant for a New York law firm. Love her or hate her, she's a topic of fascination. Carrie Nation was a radical prohibitionist who advocated for the end of alcohol consumption, partly due to the fact that her husband died from it. She used violence and a notorious hatchet to display her hatred of liquor, destroying saloons and berating people who worked for them. She is quoted as greeting bartenders with, "Good morning, destroyer of men's souls." Though she was born in Kentucky, Nation began her temperance efforts in Medicine Lodge, Kansas. She was a deeply religious woman and believed that God told her to destroy all the bars in Kiowa, Kansas, which she attempted by throwing bricks at them. Her destructive tactics continued across the state, including destroying a Wichita hotel. She was arrested multiple times and gained infamy across the nation for her tactics. Lesser known is Nation's advocacy for women's voting rights. She believed that women should and could make change. Susanna M. Salter was the first female mayor in U.S. history. Born in Ohio in 1860, Salter moved to Kansas at the age of 12, settling on a farm near Silver Lake. She then attended what is now Kansas State University, being active in prohibition movements. Salter's run for mayor of Argonia began as a cruel joke, with a group of boys, men, who were against women running for politics, putting her name in to humiliate her if she lost. Nevertheless, she vowed to accept the position if she won. So when the Women's Christian Temperance Union abandoned its preferred candidate and went behind her, she won the majority and kept her promise. Even though she only served 1 year, Salter's election gained her national attention and unimaginative newspaper headlines, like "How Women Lose Self-Respect" and "Pretty Campaigners." Despite criticism, Salter inspired women around the world, helping along a movement of equality. Nina Evans Allender was a cartoonist and women's rights activist born in Auburn. Allender became one of the first women to be employed by the federal government in Washington. She worked as an organizer, speaker, and campaigner for women's suffrage, and became the official cartoonist for the National Women's Party. Her depiction of the Allender girl showcased a young, strong American woman focused on change. The stylish portrayal helped shape a public perspective on women's rights. Allender remained active throughout her life in the fight for gender equality. Well, she seemed all right by dawn. Country singer Martina McBride grew up on a dairy farm in Sharon, Kansas. Her music career took off when she moved to Nashville with her sound engineer husband, John McBride. After landing a record deal, Martina won a spot opening up for Garth Brooks. Her first album garnered her national attention, resonating with both country and pop audiences. Outside of her lighter fare, Martina addresses heavy issues in her music, like domestic abuse and Independence Day. Let freedom ring, let the white dove sing. And child abuse in Concrete Angel. She flies to a place where she's loved. Martina has three daughters and advocates for various causes, including domestic violence against women. Dorothy DeLay was a violin instructor born in Medicine Lodge. She primarily taught at the Juilliard School, molding many world-renowned violinists into legends. She had a nurturing approach to teaching and truly believed that learning and performing should be fun, instilling confidence in her students and working with them to develop their own style. In addition to many honorary degrees, DeLay received the National Medal of Arts, the American Eagle Award, and the Sanford Medal from Yale University. Melissa Etheridge is a singer-songwriter from Leavenworth. Her confessional lyrics and raspy vocals made her an underground success in the 80s. But it wasn't until her third album, with songs like I'm Not the Only One and Come to My Window, that she became famous. Etheridge's battle with breast cancer in 2005 made her an inspiration to many. And since she came out in the early 90s, she's been an activist for gay and lesbian rights. Among her many awards are 15 Grammys and an Academy Award for Best Original Song.
I have to thank Al Gore for inspiring us, inspiring me, showing that caring about the earth is not Republican or Democrat, it's not red or blue, we are all green.
Dora Hand's enigmatic and alluring life is what movies are made of. Possibly born on the East Coast as early as 1840, legend has it that she studied music in Europe and once performed opera in New York City before coming to Dodge City. In Dodge City, she sang in saloons, earning up to $40 a week, a large sum at the time. Newspaper articles described her of having a face and voice of classic beauty, something they said made men dream of better days. Two of those men were James Spike Kennedy, a Texas cowboy, and James H. Dog Kelly, the mayor of Dodge City, who happened to own a saloon Dora performed in. When Kennedy became aggressive towards Dora one night, Kelly banned him from his saloon. So, naturally, Kennedy sought revenge and followed the mayor's daily routine, which included spending time in a cabin near the saloon. Thinking he was inside the cabin at his usual time, Kennedy drove by on horse and fired a shot. What he did not know was that Dora was inside the cabin and Kelly was gone. The shot instantly killed her, but Kennedy did not know it until he was apprehended by a gang, which included Wyatt Earp.
Did I get Kelly?
No. He killed Miss Dora.
You're lying.
Don't you never call Wyatt a liar. He's a fool to let you live, but he's telling the truth. You killed the girl!
Somehow, he was acquitted due to lack of evidence. Dora's funeral was attended by all, including 400 sombrero-wearing men riding horses behind her carriage. Some speculate that Dora is the inspiration for the role of Miss Kitty Russell in the Western Gunsmoke, also set in Dodge City.